All right, let's go back to Canberra now. Hugh Rimmington is there. You've also been talking to the opposition and I suppose getting their take on this.
That's right, Hamish. You'd think there'd be a whole lot of fresh ammunition in this budget for the opposition, not just a new sea of red ink, of course, that they can hold the government to account over, but also things like the blowout that we've seen in the asylum seeker budget, the fact that the mining tax has been really a disaster when it comes to raising the sorts of money that was earlier projected for it. The carbon pricing numbers are nowhere near their earlier projections. But there's no real sense of triumphalism from Joe Hockey, the shadow Treasurer. He knows that in a scant 4 months and one day from now, he could be sitting on the Treasury benches dealing with all these sorts of issues, grappling with things like the revenue write-downs that we've heard Wayne Swan talk about. Here was the mood from the Shadow Treasurer when I spoke to him just a short time ago. Joe Hockey, good to talk to you this evening.
Thank you, Hugh.
What do you like about this budget?
Well, it's pretty difficult to identify the things that I really like. I like the fact that the government is committed to a national disability insurance scheme, but what I'm concerned about is they're not properly funding it. And if they don't properly fund it, then they're not going to properly deliver it.
Now, they say that, in fact, that is precisely what they've done. They've mapped out the funding into many years ahead. You're not convinced?
No, because what they've done is they've taken the savings announced in previous years and they're reapplying them for... We're reapplying them for future years. So they're trying to spend the same money twice. That's what Labor does. And sadly, it's going to leave those most vulnerable in the community exposed because all the promises being made aren't going to be delivered by Labor.
They've tried to find a saving with getting rid of the baby bonus. The baby bonus was a fond creature of the Howard Costello years. Will you support the getting rid of the baby bonus?
Well, you know what, Hugh? They made changes to the baby bonus in last year's budget and they never bothered to introduce the legislation. I can't give you an item-by-item response because I've had 4 or 5 hours to look at the budget.
Still, the baby bonus is a pretty straight-up-and-down sort of thing. If you're in government, would you die in a ditch to save the baby bonus?
Well, it's not straight-up-and-down because the government cuts it over here and then re-spends it over here on a baby payment for family tax benefit Part A. It swings and roundabouts all over the budget. We'll get to the bottom of it and we'll give a considered, measured response.
Looking at these deficits, we were supposed to be in a surplus this current financial year. We're now looking at $19 billion, $18 billion in the year. We're about to enter another $11 billion after that. Where would that leave a coalition government if you were to come in after September? What's your starting position as you try to chart a way to surplus?
Labor always makes a mess. They always leave debt and deficit. It's always up to us to try and fix it up.
Do you acknowledge, though, that you would have to make deep cuts
We will have to make hard decisions, but honest decisions. And there needs to be a process and a method to those decisions. I mean, you just can't have random shots at people, at families and so on. You've got to give people certainty and stability. We're going to try and do that, and we're going to be honest before the election and honest after the election. Unlike Labor.
Do you think this budget has made it easier for the coalition to win an election?
I can't give you an answer on what the election holds. I can only give you an answer on the fact that we don't believe the budget numbers. We've been proven every year under Labor, and we're going to be proven again, sadly, tonight.
Joe Hockey, good to talk to you.
Thank you, Hugh.
Well, the budget, of course, is never just about the numbers. Entire sectors of our community are affected by the decisions made by the Treasurer. Some are celebrating tonight, others are bitterly disappointed, as Matt Moran reports.
You can never please everyone, and Wayne Swan didn't have the money to even try this year.
Tonight's budget is less Robin Hood and more Sheriff of Nottingham.
The landmark National Disability Insurance Scheme won the strongest praise.
Tonight's announcements of $14.3 billion over 7 years for the NDIS means that they will be given dignity through true choice and control.
And the axing of the baby bonus received surprise support from one quarter.
We support the principle of the reform of removing the baby bonus and putting that money into the family payment system. We think it will better target the support to families overall.
But
welfare payments remain too low.
Cuts to healthcare didn't impress doctors.
This budget is getting sick people to pay for the budget black hole. $664 million coming out of Medicare rebates.
Hardest to please, big business.
For the economy, this is a budget of band-aids and missed opportunities.
Tonight's budget has very much been put forward as a nation-building budget. However, industry would have liked to have seen the government do more in terms of heavy lifting and more in terms of funding infrastructure projects.
We just haven't seen sufficient initiatives by this government to drive growth within small business.
Each year, dozens of interest groups line up to tell us what they think of the budget. But the reality is we have an election 4 months to the day. And if the polls are correct, all of this will mean little.
Tonight we must ask one simple question. Will Tony Abbott support schools funding reform, or will he seek to dismantle Gonski schools funding reform?
Universities lost billions to help pay for that.
Tonight universities are $3.4 billion worse off than they were this time last year.
This is a budget that marks time, unfortunately, while economic reality bites.
What this budget delivers is a weaker, dumber, meaner Australia.
The opposition leader will give his response to what's likely to be Mr Swan's last budget on Thursday.